I want to encourage you today to create a safe place for those around you who may be struggling at this time. Some need space and they need permission to talk about what they are feeling in these changing, shifting, tumultuous times. Everyone is unique and some need space to comprehend and communicate what they are going through. We may feel uncomfortable about the conversation and search our minds for blanket statements to quickly resolve the dilemma because we think it's helping. We desire to see them feel better. We don't like to see people struggling. It's not a bad desire, and it is motivated by love, but it may well be robbing them of the ability to process their thoughts and feelings and cause them to push these things down to remove the added conflict. People actually need to process their feelings. They need to learn about what they are experiencing and work through the issues with understanding so that they can travel through and not just suppress the emotions that are suddenly rising up. Creating that safe place requires the skill of actively listening non-judgmentally, allowing them to express what they are feeling without cutting them off mid-sentence, even if it is with a well-meaning, truth-filled Word of God statement. I know if someone presents me with a challenge, I automatically search inside for answers, but that may not be what is required at that moment. That can come later as they are ready for answers. But firstly, they must feel heard and understood before they are ready to receive input. The right word at the wrong timing can be detrimental to their whole process of recovery. If a person has to shut down and push down, it can cause damage to their brain and to their body. Our ultimate desire is for people to come to wholeness, for them to learn how to process their thoughts and feelings in a healthy way. To help them with this, we need to ask people what they are thinking and feeling and then allow them to express these things. Before prematurely offering advice, we should ask them at the appropriate time if they would actually like our input. People need a safe place to communicate. As they learn to process through their challenges, the next time they are confronted with a similar situation, they will not erupt with pent-up emotions, but face it with much more understanding and resilience. We need to help people come to wholeness by learning how to communicate with wisdom and how to communicate with love. This is Rosanna Palmer.